rather than just being a strict like recoloring of tracks, they actually just take that theme and expand it into a bigger track. So some parts end up being the same, but they add a lot that's different. So just as a comparison, this is the Aquilaris track. You can see the green shape. Now hold on to that shape, stick it in your brain for a moment, and compare it to this. So if you look on the far right side, where it goes from the Y in city down to like the face of Bullseye Navior, that part of the track is like the beginning of the track from the previous Aquilaris. There really isn't much change there, but obviously, for the stuff that's on the left side of the screen, it ends up being a lot different. Also, what's different is your winnings. So now, if you swap it to winners take all, you're getting 3,300 trugets as compared to the 2,200 you were getting before. So it's a significant jump in the amount of trugets you can earn, which is important, remember, for buying pieces for your pod. That said, we'll take a quick spin to the junkyard, see if there's anything cool, and then we'll dive right in. Ooh,
Pretty
a
good, no
block six
doubts
thrust
there,
coil. Not bad. That's real good.
huh? Tulpa da bunky dunko.
Can we afford it though? Oh my gosh, we can.
Have
Heck
you
yeah.
seen my chance cube?
We're gonna be so fast. All right. Let's dive in, I guess. Sunken City. It kind of reminds me of like the Sydney Opera House, the design of
It's a gorgeous evening here on the ocean world Aquilaris.
The perfect setting for one of the most scenic pod races in the galaxy. Your host, the lovely and gracious governess, the Nave Mengaris.
So this opening track is pretty much identical. I actually have found I'm using the air brake, that kss sound effect you're hearing, a lot more than I thought I would be. But you kind of have to with the pod, doesn't have the turning. Man, that block thruster coil is really cranking. I don't know if you guys can see the difference compared to previous races, but I definitely feel it. Get a better turning couple like I talked about the previous one. Maybe with these 3,300 trugets, we can invest in a better turning couple just from the shop instead of hoping to get lucky with each other. Ah man, I cannot keep this boost. I mean, I'm holding the trigger all the way forward, and it just feels like, I don't know, moving my left analog stick is turning it up. Yeah, so that's what I'm used to. I was looking at the controller instead of the game. But like I talked about in the previous video, this second circuit, although the tracks are much longer, is still not really all that wow. It's really not all that more advanced than the previous one. You know, you can hold the accelerator down, you won't see a soul, and you'll probably just win even if you crash a bunch. That's... Yeah. But you see, like, if I did this in, like, the Galactic Cup, no way I'd be, like, 7th place. But this... Come on, stay boosted. It's so weird, because you need to, like, you need to hold the trigger forward, hold the accelerator, and hold axe all at the same time. And if you don't, like, if you let off, you know, the analog stick that you're pushing forward to, you know, have some control of the turn, like, it just breaks your boost. Maybe I can mess with it for a second. It's a little like this. Tight corners. Mess with the control settings and see if I can. So I'll have to do a different button. Because, like, if it were like L2 to charge your boost. That would be a lot easier to control. Easy. Scroll. I think I'm gonna next one ahead. I know there's a good opportunity to boost right up here. Not a good straight away. Not this. I'm playing the regular controller too. The other one, like the right analog stick, the left analog stick is completely screwed up. I can't make a boost. But this is, like, I don't think I've had this much issue at all yet. Kind of speaks to the ease of these races that I can be messing around with whether my boost will work or not for the entire time. And then we'll catch up. See, that one was pretty good. We got a lot of that. But that's it. What? Ho ho! There we go. Alright, guess I have to take this a little seriously. I also guess I spent too soon. I was in the middle of saying, hey, nobody's coming up to me after all this messing around with the boost. And as soon as I finish saying that. Oh, I didn't even realize he was racing against a new guy. Who is this? Bullseye Navior. I'm curious. Wow, look at that top speed and that cooling. That's nuts. Huh. Why is the top speed on all of these guys slammed to the... Oh, does it apply the parts that you have on your pod to every other pod? That doesn't make sense. Huh. Weird. Interesting. Okay. Let's see here. Rats Tyrell. Check the junkyard
You'll
just in case.
You'll not find a better deal anywhere, I think, huh?
That was indeed a better turning point.
They come here. How do they find me? They come here. They mess up my store. Hey!
Let's see what he'll actually sell for turning upgrades. A control coupling. Can I afford it? Yes. We'll take it. And better repair, we don't necessarily
means.
Better acceleration would be good though. Or traction, that works too. Can I do this?
They come here. Yep. How do they find me?
We're really starting to
mess up my store.
Welcome, pod racing fans, to Ondo Preem.
So we're on Ondo Preem again. Ondo Preem is the same planet from Beto's Wild Ride, but as you can tell, this map's already quite different. That burst. I'll go with the right time next time, see what it takes us. Oof. Turn on the right, seems pretty swift. Another sport too. That's a shortcut of some sort. Turning really. Yep, that upgrade was sick. Thud. Oh, yes. Oh my gosh, yes. This course. Come on, boost. No! Physics work in your favor, I guess. I'm going so fast, but thankfully the pod handle is much better now, so it's easy to adjust if you want to take it. Alright, so.
It's a new lap record!
What is this one? Well, what is this path look like? Can I just get at the end without running into a wall? Oh my gosh, this is way easier than all those. Obito's one of the options. Jeez. That's what I get for running into a wall with a bunch of spots outside. I next turn, and now... No, come on. Oh my gosh, am I gonna make it? So that right there is the tilting the engines down thing in action. Honestly, I definitely thought I was not making that first pinball there. There we go. Get Rats Tyrell. Ooh, some Bulba was in that race. Whew. Still, I beat the guy in second place by almost 20 seconds. Unreal. All right. I think this is the first, oh no, we have been on Malstar once. There's not much to Malstar. So now we get a different version of Malstar where Elon Musk is the new favorite. I think I played through this track in practice, which is why I've got the two first places. But with a best lap of 50 seconds, this course is pretty short. The only real problem with it is that huge turn that's almost like, it's almost a 180. Like you're doubling back on yourself. You can see it down there near Elon Musk's head. That's really the toughest part of the track. All right.
Back again, huh?
Oh yes, back again.
Putinanolia!
Oh,
you'll not find a better deal anywhere, I think, huh? Outlanders, they come here. How do they find me?
This is actually a pretty good plug.
Mess up my store, hey!
Can I get better from here?
You come back, huh?
Oh, wait, I was looking at the wrong thing. I get better repair.
You're
the rotary power plug is apparently the best repair
thing,
and it's right there in the junkyard for much cheaper. We'll buy it, it'll get fixed after the race, and it'll do more.
No doubts then, huh?
Alright. Let's punch it. This will be the last race we do. We try and only do 3 laps, and the engineers are kept to about 20 minutes in time. What is that? What is that? Just some weird Terminator man?
I can hold it next to me.
Opening turn. Ah, missed a shortcut. I'm trying to remember who would what. Oh, ho, he's doing a run for me. Okay, that turns into a sharp. Watch that. There we go. That's seems to be working all right now. Honestly, that was a lot shorter than I thought. What other cool upgrades can I get for this mod? Since that race was quicker than I thought, I will actually do one more. We'll do Scrapper's Run. But I'm gonna need to make a quick junkyard.
Stop.
Block 5 coil that's weaker than mine.
Your banana pihota, Mindia, huh? Only the best parts you find here in my shop, huh? I am betting heavily on Sebulba. He always wins.
And the one who
the wind is howling here at the abandoned gas mines aboard Ibana. Or is that the crowd? These scrap gangs sure love a good pod race, and we have got one for you today.
Scrap. All right. this track is pretty much all turn oriented, if I recall. There's not a lot of opportunities. Yep, so this straightaway is actually one of the interesting. So remember that for lap number two. Yeah. Come on. There we go. Ooh, boy. Alright. Something to worry about next. Oh, boy. So, the reason I did that there is because I didn't want to run into him and break both our pods. Wow, guess I didn't. Whew, I remember that 9-degree turn. Yikes. I was thinking that there were a lot more turns to this track, but I guess I was wrong. In any case, if I just hit the accelerator, I'll hold the phone now. I just want to boost, baby. Oh man, I even held the brake there to slow down. It's gonna be a problem. I might need to get, invest in a new controller if this is gonna be the app because I can't go into the like galactic circuit and have, you know, not be able to boost. Come on, there we go. Can't prepare yet, he's right on my tail. I can see those yellow dots threatening me. Come on. Oh yeah, that locks it up. Another trip race. Alright, we blew through half the circuit in no time at all. That pod is so funky. One sandage. One sandage. One Sanchez. One sandals. It's such a weird name. I mean, all of the names are, but one sandage. I don't know, maybe it's because it just sounds like it could be an actual real person's name. Like, nobody's named Aldar, but, you know, Juan spelled like J-U-A-N, like Juan Sandage, like that seems like it could be an actual person's name. I don't know. Alright, we'll cap it there. Four races down, and we've got three more to go in this circuit, and I will see you guys next time.